वन और इधर चॉइस टू डिड नॉट सेलेक्ट द अदर चॉइसेस यू विल गेट पार्शियल मार्क्स. ओके सो द क्वेश्चन इज द रूटीन्स ऑफ सम इंडिविजुअल्स आर गिवन बिलो. सेलेक्ट द इंडिविजुअल्स हु डिमॉन्स्ट्रेट द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट टेंडेंसीज ऑफ बींग अ मोबर्ड. ओके सो देर आर फाइव ऑप्शन सिक्स ऑप्शन अवेलेबल. सो द आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन विल बी ऑप्शन नंबर ए डेट इज Sneha is attending the farewell party of one of her colleagues. Throughout the event, she takes pictures of her Instagram and posts stories about what is happening at the party. She is constantly busy making these posts and checking the responses she is getting to them. Okay, and the other answer for this question will be ऑप्शन नंबर फाइव डेट इज रीता हैज़ जस्ट मूव्ड इन टू हर न्यू होम इन अ न्यू सिटी इन ऑर्डर टू मेक थिंग्स ईजी फॉर हर सेल्फ. सी शॉप्स फॉर फर्नीचर डिकोर बेडिंग एंड टॉयलेट्रीज ऑनलाइन. सी कंसिडर्स गोइंग आउट एंड एक्सप्लोरिंग अननेसेसरी थिंग्स. सो सी ऑर्डर्स ऑल हर ग्रॉसरीज फ्रॉम एप्स एंड यूजेस अदर एप्स टू लर्न हाउ टू कुक न्यू काइंड्स ऑफ डिशेज. ओके फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर वन ऑप्शन ए डेट इज स्नेहा एंड ऑप्शन नंबर ई डेट इज रीता विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. ओके मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन नंबर टू इज डोना हरावे स्टेट्स मशीन इज गिवन ह्यूमन ट्रीटमेंट एंड ह्यूमन्स आर ट्रीटेड लाइक मशीन्स. बिलो आर अ फ्यू इंस्टांसेस इन आइडेंटिफाई ऑल द ऑप्शंस वेयर दिस कोड अप्लाइज. सो द आंसर फॉर दिस विल बी ऑप्शन नंबर ए डेट इज इन अ सेल सेंटर द एम्प्लॉयज मस्ट टेक अ सर्टेन नंबर ऑफ कॉल्स पर डे. दे आर कॉन्स्टेंटली मॉनिटर्ड फॉर कॉल ड्यूरेशंस कस्टमर सेटिस्फैक्शन एंड इवन द नंबर ऑफ ब्रेक्स दे टुक एंड द टाइम दे टुक टू हैव देयर लंच. नो रिगार्ड इज पेड टू द एम्प्लॉयज इंडिविजुअल स्किल्स एंड मेंटल एंड फिजिकल वेलबींग. ओके दिस वन इज करेक्ट. ऑप्शन नंबर बी डेट इज जुहा रिसेंटली बाउट अ न्यू लैपटॉप. सी बाइज एसेसरीज फॉर द लैपटॉप एवरी टाइम सी फाइंड्स अ न्यू वन इन द मार्केट. सी अपग्रेड्स इट with whenever needed and takes good care of its cleanliness. Okay, meanwhile her younger sister Zoya has been pining for her attention for a long time and has been requesting Zoya to help her in her studies. Zoya neither spends time with her nor pays heed to her calls for help. Okay, and the other one that is the correct will be option number E that is Farhan. Farhan has recently purchased a new car and he takes good care of it. However, whenever he gives someone a ride, he is very peculiar about whether their clothes are clean or not, and he is rude to them if they touch anything in the car. Okay, so for question number two, the correct answer will be ऑप्शन नंबर ए डेट इज इन अ कॉल सेंटर. ओके ऑप्शन नंबर बी डेट इज जुहाज एंड ऑप्शन नंबर ई डेट इज फरहान हैज रिसेंटली. ओके क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड इज सुषमा इज अ मोबाइल एडिक्ट एंड इट हैज नॉट ओनली काउज्ड चेंजेस इन हर पर्सनैलिटी बट ऑल्सो अफेक्टेड हर रिलेशनशिप्स विद अदर पीपल. What should Sushma do to reclaim her human personality and get rid of this addiction? Okay, so the answer for question number third will be option number A. Sushma should use a wristwatch to minimize her frequent phone use to check time. Option number C that is while driving, Sushma should put her phone away. And option number E that is use notepads, memo pads and to-do lists to write down important tasks instead of using mobile apps. And the last option that is select a certain duration of the day when she does not use the phone. Okay, so the answer for question number third will be option number one, option number three, option number five, option number six. Okay, question number four is which of the following options are a demonstration of the cardinal principles of soft skills. So for question number four, the correct answer will be option number See, that is Ravi is late in joining an important course. He writes the following email to the professor. Dear professor, my name is Ravi Kumar and I am an independent research scholar. I have been following your work, which aligns with my research area, for years, and it has proven helpful to me. It would be an honor for me to be able to learn from you in the course you are offering this year. I understand that the deadline has passed. I apologize for this late request, but it would be an enormous opportunity for me to learn from you in a person. Please consider this humble request of mine. I am attaching my CV with this email. Please take a look at my credentials and work before you make a decision. Best regards, Ravi Kumar. So this one will be the correct one. And option number D, that is Kaiser has been selected for an interview. He prepares beforehand some of the anticipated questions, reaches the venue half an hour early to get familiar with the place and make sure he is looking neat and clean before the interview. This one is correct. And the last one, that is Priya has started learning to stitch, but she doesn't seem to show any progress despite her efforts. She feels anxious about this but keeps on trying harder each day to learn better. She practices the stitches she learns and takes extra classes when necessary. Okay, for question number 4, option number 3, option number 4 and option number 6 will be the correct answer. Okay, question number 5 is Vishal is writing an email to his class professor. Read the email and choose the correct options. Hey sir, I gotta go on a vacay and will be bunking your classes for a week. Please provide notes for the missed classes. Thanks, Vishal. So for question number 5, the correct answer will be option number 8, that is attention needs to be paid to the punctuation in this email. Option number 3, that is using text messages, words like your, please, thanks are not appropriate for this email. Option number E, okay, that is in the case of the situation, words like respected or dear must be used instead of hey, okay. And the last option, that is the language needs to be modified to be appropriate for an official email, will be the correct options. Okay, so for question number 5, let's recheck it. Option number 1, option number 3, option number 5 and option number 6 will be the correct answers. Question number 6 is, who among us the below mentioned people are following the right netiquette? Okay, so the answer for question number 6 will be option number C, that is while writing emails, Sohib always keeps in mind that the fact that he is writing to another human being. This makes him write politely and without unnecessarily mean remarks. Okay, this one is the correct one. And option number D, that is Radha is an Instagram user. Whenever she comes across a good post on someone's profile, she comments with words of appreciation and genuine compliments. At times, she shares the posts that are made by other users and credits them in her reports. Okay, this one is the correct one. And the last one, that is Subha is an art manager and she receives dozens of art portfolios every day through the mail. She regularly responds to these emails with encouragement even when she cannot carry out their requests. She makes sure that the portfolios are not misused or plagiarized from the hardcore computers. Okay, so this one is the correct one. So for question number 6, option number 3, option number 4 and option number 6 will be the correct answers. Okay, question number 7 is, which of the following circumstances show the crucial need for netiquette? Okay, for question number 7, the correct answers will be option number B, that is an insecure बॉयफ्रेंड हैक्स इनटू हिज गर्लफ्रेंड्स इंस्टाग्राम अकाउंट टू चेक इफ सी इज चैटिंग विद समवन एल्स. ऑप्शन नंबर सी डेट इज अ टीनेजर क्रिएट्स अ फेक अकाउंट एज एन एडल्ट टू एक्सेस साइट्स फॉरबिडन टू अंडर एज पीपुल. ओके ऑप्शन नंबर बी, ऑप्शन नंबर सी, ऑप्शन नंबर डी डेट इज अ स्टूडेंट यूजेस हिज टीचर्स नेम एंड ईमेल्स हिज क्लासमेट्स टू कलेक्ट फंड्स फ्रॉम देम. एंड ऑप्शन नंबर ई, ओके दैट इज अ पर्सन हु इज यूजुअली शाय इन पब्लिक क्रिएट्स अ फेक फेसबुक अकाउंट टू बली पीपुल. फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर सेवन, ऑप्शन नंबर टू, ऑप्शन नंबर थ्री, ऑप्शन नंबर फोर, ऑप्शन नंबर फाइव आर द करेक्ट आंसर्स. ओके मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर एट इज हाउ कैन वन बी केयरफुल टू मेक सेंस ऑफ वंस ईमेल. ओके सो द आंसर फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर एट विल बी ऑप्शन नंबर ए, मेक नोट्स अबाउट व्हाट यू वांट टू कॉन्वे इन योर ईमेल्स. ऑप्शन नंबर डी दैट इज प्रिपेयर अ रफ ड्राफ्ट ऑफ द ईमेल बिफोर फेयरिंग इट आउट. ओके एंड ए डी, ऑप्शन नंबर ई दैट इज प्लान द ईमेल बिफोर हैंड. ऑप्शन एफ डू नॉट एग्जागरेट बी कॉन्साइज क्लियर एंड कोहेरेंट. ओके फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर एट, ऑप्शन नंबर वन, ऑप्शन नंबर फोर, ऑप्शन नंबर फाइव, ऑप्शन नंबर सिक्स आर द करेक्ट वंस. ओके क्वेश्चन नंबर नाइन इज वन ऑफ द ईमेल एटिक्वेट रेट्स स्पेंड एन एक्स्ट्रा मिनट टू सेव एन आवर ऑफ द रिसीवर. What actions are expected of the sender during this extra minute? So the answer for question number 9 will be option number A that is editing the content of the email. Option number D that is checking spellings and correcting wherever possible. Option number E that is dividing lengthy matter into readable matter. And option number F that is deciding if the mail is relevant or irrelevant and unsolicited. Okay so for question number 9, option number 1, option number 4, option number 5, option number 6 will be the correct answer. Question number 10 is pick the correct email etiquette from the following options. So the correct answer for question number 10 will be avoid random CCing and do not reply to all, option number A. Option number D that is avoid typing in full capital letters, and option number F, okay, that is use abbreviations discreetly. For question number 10, option A, option D and option F will be the correct answers. Question number 11, what is meant by the term cybernetics? So options are cybernetics is a term used in marketing and advertising referring to the use of internet based technologies and social media platforms to promote products and services to consumers. Option number B is it is the study of the internet in a cold climate. Option number C is it is a term used to describe the benefits of cyberspace in communication during warfare. Option number E is it is a branch of, option number D is it is a branch of computer science focused solely on developing cyber security protocols and algorithms to protect digital systems from hacking and data breaches. Option number E is it is the study of control system, and option number F is it is the ability to control technology for the benefit of humankind. Okay so the correct answer for question number 11 will be option number E that is it is the study of control systems. Okay question number 12 is what does the story of the father and his new car reveal to us. Options are children will always be excited to ride on new cars and we should appreciate and encourage it. Option number B is we should keep sharp objects such as nails out of children's reach so that they cannot play with them and cause damage to the certain property. Option number See, is we have let a machine become part or parcel of ourselves to have to the extent that we are not able to distinguish between the machine and the human. Option number D is the scratches on cars are temporary and can be fixed easily at a good car repair center. Option number E is kids should be dealt with harshly for damaging property, so they learned they are important. And option number F is cars are an unnecessary investment because children will damage them eventually. So the correct answer for question number 12 will be option number C. Okay, we have let a machine become part or parcel of ourselves to the extent that we are not able to distinguish between the machine and the human. Question number 13 is which of the following people displays the correct mobile etiquette. Okay, so options are Rahat makes use of face-to-face communication to the maximum extent. He makes sure that he does not unnecessarily call people who can be visited or talked to in a person, such as people in the same house. Supriya always calls people to ask about trivial things, even if a text message had sufficed the purpose. She would have called people on the phone. Raj does not care about his wife's work schedule and calls her whenever he likes because he thinks she can always make time for him. Mala planned to discuss an important topic with her professor and call him without seeking a prior appointment through email or text message. Sarah does not keep her phone silent during business meetings because she does not want to miss out any activity on her social media account. Rui has a habit of talking loudly on the phone even when she is in the public place. Okay, so for question number 13, option number A will be the correct answer. Question number 14 is, according to Marlian was 7, what among the following is the characteristic of communication in the present era of instant messaging and cell phones? Options are organized, linear, disoriented, disorganized, hierarchical, speedy. So the correct answer for question number 14 will be option number F, that is speedy. Okay. Question number 15 is, Priyanka is an Instagram influencer who recently signed a contract to sell a newly launched cell phone. She did a special Instagram story in which she highlighted the features of the phone. She took photographs to show the phone's picture quality and gave special discounts to her followers. Which cardinal principle is Priyanka demonstrating? So the options are planning, preparedness, presentability, persuasiveness, perseverance, and pervasiveness. Okay, so the correct answer for this question will be option number D, that is persuasiveness. Okay, question number 16 is, if you miss an important lecture in your course and have written an email to the professor asking for help with the material, which of the following statements will be the most appropriate subject line? Okay, options are missed calls, missed class, need information, help, request for makeup material with a date, stuff from the last class, hey ma'am, question about the lecture. So the answer for question number 16 will be option number C, request for makeup material with a date. Okay, question number 17 is, select the correct set of words that form the term netiquette. Options are net worth, internet etiquette, network, internet etiquette, Netflix, intranet, banquet, internet etiquette, network etiquette, network, intranet etiquette. So the correct one for question number 17 will be internet etiquette. Okay, option number D. Question number 18 is, what does the term netiquette mean? So for question number 18, the correct answer will be, it describes the norms and expected behavioral patterns in cyberspace communication, that is mentioned in option number C. Okay, question number 19 is, which of the following options describes the content on the internet correctly? Options are, any ordinary content uploaded to the internet becomes extraordinary after posting content online, it gets permanently deleted after 30 days, Content on the internet can be stored permanently. The internet is a controlled space where only factual and authorized information is available. Advertising and marketing are the sole purposes of the internet. The content on the internet is edited by a group of elves. So the correct answer for question number 19 will be option number C, that is content on the internet can be stored permanently. Question number 20 is fill in the blanks. We just have to fill the blanks with the right statement, okay? For question number 20, question number 20 is complete the following quote by Porter Stewart. Ethics is knowing the difference between what you have a right to do and death. So the correct answer for question number 20 will be option number E, that is what is right to do, okay? From here, the questions are in the form of true and false. We just have to answer the given statement is true or false, okay? So question number 21 is taking notes before an important call violates mobile etiquette. Is this statement true or false? So given statement is false, okay? Moving to the next one. The internet has led to an increase in the emotional intelligence of the human race through its strengths of communication. Is this statement true or false? So again, this one is false one. For question number 23, we have no control over our emails once they are sent. So this one is again false. Question number 24 is all is fair in love, war and cyberspace. Is this true or false? So again, false is the correct answer for this question. Question number 25 is when the subject line of an email is occupied by multiple reply signs such as it signifies our persistence in the following an email thread, okay? So before telling you the correct answer for question number 25, I'm requesting you to please like the video, okay? And please share it with needy ones, okay? So the correct answer for question number 25 will be option number B, that is false. So we have solved all the questions. Let's submit it. Viewers, thanks for watching the video. Thank you.